Hello, Relayers. When we started this journey a few hours ago, we said that we were here together to fight a disease that never sleeps. Although we can't do this out on the track tonight, I wanted to thank those who made this year's virtual event a success. So thank you to all of the teams, participants, survivors, and caregivers who made sure this year's relay still happened. Without you, cancer wins, but with you, we save lives.
We all come to Relay for the same basic reasons. We may have fought cancer ourselves or watched someone we love fight in this battle. So together we relay. We relay to celebrate the lives of those who have battled cancer. Relay gives us a place to rejoice in the presence of those who have emerged victorious in their battle.
We relay to remember. To remember the lives that we've lost. We remember the journeys that we've walked with our loved ones. And relay to keep their memory alive. We also relay to get comfort and healing within a community that has experienced similar loss and can understand our grief.
In both celebrating those that we love and remembering the lives that we have lost, we are motivated to take action so that no one has to hear the words, "You have cancer." We are here virtually, but together, to fight back. We've all lost too many people that we love. We must fight back to honor the memories of those that cancer has taken away from us too soon. We must fight back so we can live in a world with more birthdays.
Now, I would like to introduce our speaker, Stephen Goldberg.
Hello, everyone. My name is Steve Goldberg, and I am a cancer survivor. The journey that got me here today began in April of 2017, when my wife and I had just came back from wintering in Florida. And she noticed that I didn't look good, that I looked a little yellow and pale and yellow. So I went to my primary care physician and immediately he noticed that I was jaundiced. He had me take some blood tests and he suspected that I might have cancer. And he decided that I have to go into Boston to go get further tests. My family and I researched the hospitals in Boston and decided that our best bet was to go to Dana-Farber Brigham and Women's. When we got there, they took more tests and they confirmed that I had stage 3 pancreatic cancer. Now, I did some research on it. Was never said to me openly, but I did the research. I found was that the pancreatic cancer that I had is a 7% survival rate. Obviously, that wasn't very encouraging, but I had to go forward. The first step was I had to have surgery. It was called Whipple surgery, and it was done by a few. It's only done by a few people, by a few physicians in Boston. And we researched and found out that who was the best physician to do this. This Whipple surgery is 3-hour surgery, and the recovery is long and arduous. And it would determine how far the cancer had progressed. So obviously went ahead, did the surgery. It was 6 hours, and when I came out of surgery, he told my wife and my daughters that he thought that he got all the cancer, but that I was going to have to go through chemotherapy. We met with the oncologist, and the protocol was as follows. I was going to have to go through 16 weeks of chemotherapy. The way it was this. Every Monday, for 3 weeks, I'd go into the Dana-Farber, get blood taken, get a physical, meet the oncologist, and she explained to me the numbers that were the blood numbers that showed how far and the cancer had lessened during this time. So for 3 weeks, I would go in, I'd have my blood taken, examined, and then I would have the cancer medicine in given to me intravenously. That would take approximately an hour, and after that, I would have to take some oral medication. This went on for 3 consecutive weeks. The 4th week, I did nothing. Had no medication, didn't do any, I didn't have to go visit the cancer center at all, Dana-Farber at all. I have to tell you, it was very debilitating to me. I was constantly tired, I had no appetite, and it was just like, you just gotta put one foot in front of the other and keep going, because there was no other alternative. Every Monday, my wife would take me in. She'd stay with me while I was examined. She'd stay with me during my infusion period. One thing I forgot to mention is that I am really grateful and appreciative to the Masco students who run this Relay for Life. And for the past 2 years, I was so happy and proud to walk around the track.
Thank you for sharing your story. You're one of the many reasons that we are here today fighting this battle. Together, we have taken action. We've ensured that millions of cancer survivors will now experience their own birthdays this year, but we will not stop here. Thank you for inspiring us to keep fighting.